Good evening, everyone. The Centers for Disease Control has released new numbers in the national meningitis outbreak.
So far, 119 cases have now been reported nationwide, including 11 deaths. Here in Maryland, the number of meningitis cases is also on the rise. 11 News reporter Sheldon Dutes is live at the State Health Department in West Baltimore with the latest. Sheldon.
Well, Donna, so far 8 cases have been reported across the state, including one person who's already died. Now, the state health department will not tell us where these cases have been diagnosed, and they won't release any other specific information. But overall, the number has increased by 5 from last week alone.
The death toll from a nationwide fungal meningitis outbreak has climbed to 11, including one person from Maryland. Of the hundreds of cases that have already been reported in 10 states, 8 of them are from Maryland, and health officials think that number could rise.
What they found with this fungal contamination is it's an incubation period of about a week to 4 weeks. So it can be quite a period of time between when people got the injection and when they start showing symptoms, and the symptoms tend to come on slowly.
How did all of this happen? The fungal meningitis outbreak has been linked to contaminated steroid shots that relieve back pain. Health officials believe the contaminated medicine was made by the New England Compounding Center in Massachusetts and then shipped to 23 states. Fungal meningitis is the most rare of the three types of meningitis infections, but it's not that easy to get sick with.
If I have not received one of these injections, I should not be concerned.
Absolutely not. It is not contagious, and if you did not get one of these injections, you should not be concerned.
The New England Compounding Center has since recalled all of its products, and affected facilities here in Maryland have already started reaching out to patients who might have been impacted. Massachusetts Congressman Ed Markey says the outbreak has exposed gaps in oversight that need to be addressed.
The state does not have full authority. The federal government does not have full authority. And as a result, within a regulatory black hole, this company is allowed to sell drugs all across the United States without the FDA on the job.
And the specialty pharmacy at the heart of this meningitis outbreak has voluntarily pulled its license and also pulled all of its products. For a full list of all of the Maryland facilities that have possibly been affected, just head to our website, WBALTV.com, and click on Medical Alert. Reporting live at the State Health Department in West Baltimore, Sheldon Dutes, WBAL-TV 11 News.